visitors from CIC,
and also our parishioners
here. So it's a great privilege for me to introduce Father Rayapada Kasi from Benue Diocese. He's a diocesan priest who is very much involved with the environment. He just a brief conversation with him that he was already into environment even before now that was came out. So basically you can say that Pope Francis is giving us then from full 20 years when he started. So without further delay, I'd like to introduce Father.
It is an Italian literature, so such a simple poem. He wrote for the, you know, the five elements of the earth, soil, water, air, fire, and ether. So the five basic elements of the earth. So, praise be to you, my Lord. Care for our common home, only one home. That's a faithful verse. On the cover of the book, he writes, care for our common home. In other words, we don't have another home. We destroy this home, that's it. That is no other home for us. Only that, we are sharing this home with other creatures. That's the wrong way. Actually, creatures are sharing their home with us. That is because they came to us. So, we need to thank all other creatures for accepting us. We are the last human, last living creature to appear in the great chain of beings. So, we are the little brother and we are the little sister. There is no little brother after us. Nothing came. We are the last one. And we are not allowing other creatures to come after us. That is arrogance. So, brother of all in our family, without him, there is no food, there is no life, there is no warmth. He is the breadwinner for all creatures, and he makes food for all our family. So brothers, then he puts it, sister moon. See, brother sun, sister moon, brother wind. Ah, without brother wind, you can't sit down here. We need wind. We need every breath. Depends on the wind. It's a brother wind. And brother fire. And sister water.
Anyway, by the way, is there any water for me here? Sister water? I need some sister water, David. Otherwise, I'm going to choke now. If I can get the sister.
It's instructing what to do international dialogue on the environment and the international. So if you are looking for solutions internationally, you read this part and you will understand internationally what humanity should be. Main point is dialogue. Dialogue is also human ecology. You are dialoguing with your resources. So 7.5 million people, they bring their resources and put them on the table and dialogue. So that is human ecology. Again, human ecology as the positive effect on solving ecological crisis. The second is local and state. I offer new national local policies that for Asia, India, because there is no universal recipes. It is every country has their own problems. Situation is different. So you need to sort out using the same methodology, see, judge, act. So the same methodologies, you can solve all your problems in your country. Logical insights are there, I don't want to enter into theology, because theology is a boring subject. Because we always study theories of one, but we don't use much of what we have learned. But it's a viewpoint of theology, very interesting. But that you can read and find for yourself, the point is not theology, but I'm going to give you a practical application of theology. That is very important. So I'm going to dial in this subject into three small topics. The first one is ecological education. Pope thinks that ignorance is the cause of all evil. Plato said 300 years before Christ, ignorance is the cause of all evil. Ignorance. Because we don't know how the systems work and how everything is structured. What is an ecosystem? What is an environment? What is carbon cycle? What is hydrologic cycle? What is nitrogen cycle? And what is a biome? What is a living component? What is non-living component? There are so many things about ecology we don't know. We are only human species, it's ecology and environment. Nothing is out there. So that made us ignorant. So all the problems is the outcome of our ignorance. So whether you teach ecological education, this is the first thing, the stars of the family, mother and father, they should be really trained in ecological matters. Alright? So you become a professor, you become a chancellor. When Tamil song, beautiful Tamil song, their family is a university, it is what the translation. A family is a kind of university. In university, you have got mathematics, history, geography, all sections mathematics subjects. But in family, you really teach the subject which are not at all taught in any other university in the world. In family, the father and mother are the chancellors, they are the professors, and at last they give you the PhD or MA or BA degree in love, in compassion, in tolerance, in sacrificing. Very important subjects. That is the subject where every kid should have a meeting. The other things one could make money, but to have a better life, I think this university really should invest. The father and mother, ecology education is the first class education a parent can give to their children. It's the best investment. So now, 213, Pope writes, ecological thing, you are thinking suddenly farmed in Germany, what does it mean? Actually, this sentence can be understood only through education. That's why I put that sentence. How? See this here. Orangutan, that is your age, Malaysian age. This is the Borneo orangutan. There is also Sumatra orangutan. There are two species there. So this one, through genetic study, ecological education, we understand orangutan, how many genes are identical in the human genetics. Now we can compare medically. The scientific research tells us that 96% of the orangutan DNA is identical. In other words, orangutan is 96% human being. Actually, the kingdom, the sub-kingdom, the phylum, the genus, the family, the order, everything is the same for human also. From top to order and family level, everything is, they also belong to family called Hominoidea. We are also Hominoidea. Only species that will be changed, we are Homo sapiens. So they are all included in our family. So this is 96%. Look at that. That knowledge is acquired through ecological education. any other names. And this is Godila. Other three great apes, they are known as the great apes. One is Asian, the other three are African. This is Godila, 97% identical with human DNA. They are from Uganda, Tanzania, they live on the equator. They tell humans, they send a message, hey humans, you know best place to live for you? Equator, 20 degree north, 20 degree south. They are telling you, go, that is not the place to live for humans. That is for the polar bears. That is 60 degree, 80 degree north. Humans will never go live there. So the great apes are telling us. That's a message. So best is equator. All the apes in orangutan, equator, I think 20 degree south or 10 degree south. These are exactly equator. Uganda, Tanzania,